Member ako, nag-umisa ako as board member, I was coaching. Naging three-term ako vice governor, I was coaching. Naging congressman ako, I was coaching. So I don't think there's any reason na kailangan ingilumisa. As long as you can responsibly do both. So we've been able to find a middle ground for that. Balancing, being disciplined with the management of your time. So we were able to answer yung responsibilities natin, both for our work as a basketball coach and our work as a legislator. So, na-try ko na, nasubukan ko na, nagawa naman. And I've been in politics, our family has been in politics for the last 30 years. Hindi naman nagka-problema, especially with also my commitments to coaching basketball.
How do you compare po yung challenges ng being a coach and being a legislative po?
May mga maraming similarities, actually. So, number one is, you have to be able to prepare for both. You cannot go to your game unprepared. And you cannot go to your work in Congress unprepared. So, it's a habit and it's a lifestyle that you need to practice in order to be effective. Pareho, may mga intriga sa basketball, may mga intriga din sa politika, may intriga din sa showbiz, syempre, baka mas marami. Pero, you have to handle those things really well. And you have to be emotionally stable kasi pagbasa ka lang ng social media, everybody's bashing you. So, pagbasa ka lang ng dyaryo, ganun din. If you lose your sa basketball kasi, may kasabihan kami mga coaches, you're only as good as your last game. Baka sa movies, ganun din, you're only as good as your last
movie,
as your last project. So, the pressure is great. You can lose your job the next day. You can get fired the next day. Mabuti nga sa politika, at least alam mo may term ka. May tatlong taon ka. Pero sa coaching, pagka hindi nagustuhan yung team owner mo, yung nangyari the last game, the next day you may get fired. And it's part of our job. We have to accept that. Those are some similarities siguro na there's always pressure. There's always pressure on both the political end and on both the sports end, especially because it's a competition. Hindi kami sumali dito sa PBA para lang maglaro. Sumali kami sa PBA para manalo. So it is not enough that you're playing. Your management will look for results. The same way in Congress, after 3 years, hindi ka nakapagdala ng resulta sa distrito mo, baka the next election, wala ka na.
So if there's one thing you wanna give up and you wanna push through, ano po yung pupush na
yung... Sabi, mamimili nga isa.
Opo.
Mahirap yun, ah. Actually, I've been coaching almost 30 years. I've been coaching almost 30 years. Malapit na rin siguro yung oras na kailangan
ko
na ipasa, no? Yung torch to some other younger guys. So kung may gigibab ako, baka it's more of the coaching job because I've done a lot of that already. Then I can focus on yung service to your constituents. So, siguro, kung mamimili ako, yun ang magiging direction.
Sir,
our local party, Meron pa ding local party. It's called Kambilan. It is the party of Governor Pineda. Kasama po siya ever since no, Vice Governor, alam mo, Governor na siya. So that is our local alliance. Sa national, wala. So meron kami sa probinsya. Meron kami sarili na namin partido.
So we are privileged today to be joined by Gilas and Alex Players. Let's welcome Poy Erang, Asi Taulava, and Kiefer Rappel. They will be providing us testimonials and endorsements as well as to how Coach Angel is as a leader. Sir, as in, the reason I wanted to start, how is Coach Engao as a coach and why are you endorsing him to be a good congressman for the first time?
It's been an honor to be there for my career, my coach. You know, him having me on NLX to go into the national team, give me an opportunity to play on the national team. It's going to be a great feeling. You know, not only am I playing for the head coach, my niece, before I retire, I'll be playing for a conference, you know, the head coach of the PBA. It's a big brain game. I love the sports program. I'm not really into the other political side, knowing how I think it's supposed to be politics, but we were just in Congress and we saw all the sports facilities that were developing. Getting ready for the SEA Games. And I think coach being a congressman, you know, a lot more can be done on the project to improve it. Make it better for the future of these sports. That's with our athletes, the young generation. They need good facilities to train and at the same time competing. Because been competing in international competition for a while, it's different outside of Manila, where athletes get special training to get themselves ready to compete against the best in Asia. And not just in Asia, we're looking at the bigger picture, and that's the Olympics and the World Cups, you know, all the big events. And I think Coach at the helm, and I'm basically as congressman, I think he can introduce that, you know, more on the political side. And I'm here, it's the old man, you know, you got the team, CYG's thing going on right now to support it, and hold him like that. I think all the teammates, you know, all our teammates on the national team, if you guys want to use us to be more visible with Coach on promoting campaign,
so
we're all here for
him.
He's got a big group.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. Well, just the short time that I've been here with NLX, I've been around coaching, the coaching staff, and one thing that really instilled in our organization is him being very genuine towards one another. If he wants to say something to you, that's really for you to improve on and really for your sake. And probably nowadays it's very important to find people who are genuine with this campaign as congressman. With the help of his advocacies, his sports programs, or whatever facilities that ginagawa, help especially the youth in Pampanga. It's going to be straight from the heart. Yun yung pinakanagutunan ko talaga sa short time na nandito kay coaching. Especially when what happened in my scenario, it could have been easy for me to, for them to let go of me, napabayaan ako. But, isa sa mga tao talagang supporta and really fought for me to be able to play as soon as possible. And you know, it helps to having those people up top, the leaders, gives you confidence to do your own thing. Kasi alam mo, may mga tao na may direction para sa'yo. And yun yung ginagawa ni Coach Cheng. I'm a second generation player from my my dad did na ako na under my coaching. Wala akong narinig kundi lots of players wanting to play for him, knowing that this type of play is what you want as a player, because it will give you all the confidence you need to become the best player possible. And just like with his advocacies, gagawin niya lahat with resignation and yung fun stuff. Schools, state universities, to increase and give more opportunities and put the students in better position to be successful in life and give them better opportunities in the future. So I guess just like what Priyasi said, as long as it doesn't involve any basketball activities, I'll be open to help out coaching with his campaign. And because we believe that what he's fighting for is something really scarce right now in our society. And finding genuine people is very difficult nowadays. And being around him was the early part of my career. Hopefully, until I stop playing basketball, mas mararamdaman mo yung sincerity ng coaching. So, if gets elected, I'm pretty sure the people of Pacquiao will definitely feel his sincerity in being a genuine person towards caring for the people.